Garissa Senator Mohammed Yusuf Haji, who recently chaired the Building Bridges Initiative Task Force, was on Monday evening buried at the Langata Muslim Cemetery. Haji passed on Monday morning at the age of 80 at the Aga-Khan Hospital in Nairobi after ailing for a long time. From the hospital, his remains were taken at the Riverside Drive home in Nairobi for the better part of Monday morning, giving friends, family and colleagues ample time to trickle in. He was flown to Turkey for treatment late last year, but returned to the country on Saturday when his health stabilized. According to the family sources, who also say that he suffered multiple organ failure leading to his death. Haji, the father of Director of Public Prosecution Nudin Haji, was a long-time administrator who served in various areas, including the vast Rift Valley between 1970 and 1998. He was nominated to Parliament in 2002, and in 2007 he was elected to Parliament and opposed as a Jara Member of Parliament. Haji was the Minister of Defence from 2008 to 2013 during Mwai Kibaki's administration and briefly served as the Acting Minister of Internal Security and Provincial Affairs in 2012. It was during his tenure when the Kenya Defence Forces troops were deployed to Somalia to fight Al-Shabaab. At the time of his death, Haji was serving his second term as the Garissa Senator. Haji was a known peacemaker, mostly working on the reconciliation effort between warring clans. In 2014, Haji oversaw the signing of a peace agreement between communities in Wajir and Mandera counties to end the perennial clashes. In 2015, Haji served as the chairman of the Senate National Security and Foreign Relations Committee. Haji proposed that individuals from indigenous communities to be recruited in security team to help fight against cattle rustling because of their knowledge of terrains. He also proposed the establishment of border post to check the proliferation of illegal firearms and budgetary allocation to help communities restock as other measures to curb the crime that had led to deaths. The late Garissa Senator also called on the government to declare border rolls a national disaster, claiming it was the next big insecurity threat after Al-Shabaab. President Uhuru Kenyatta led other leaders in mourning the Garissa Senator. In his condolences, Kenyatta eulogized the veteran politician as a trusted, dependable and patriotic Kenyan. Outlining Haji's role in the BBI process, President Kenyatta said his death is a big blow to the country, especially in the BBI constitution reform process, where his leadership shall be dearly missed. The president attended Haji's burial in Nairobi just hours after attending the funeral service of the late Simeon Nyachae in Gusii Stadium in Kisii County. Deputy President William Ruto described the late lawmaker as a devoted, indefatigable administrator who was cause-driven. Dolly Mwirigi for Hope TV News Watch.